I've had clients say, Emyrald, one session with you was more powerful than the years of therapy I've had. And so when I really started to look at things in the bigger picture, how much are people spending on therapy? What's the emotional cost of having this unhealthy relationship with your stepmother, for example? But then also, what's the monetary bonuses of, like, holy shit, the majority of my clients have gotten $10,000 to $50,000 raises while working together? Like, well, that's a no-brainer. And so I started looking at all of this together, in addition to what's the value of being in a healthy relationship, or what's the cost of being in an unhealthy relationship? What's the cost of divorce financially, emotionally, on the kids, et cetera, et cetera. And just the bigger long-term picture of, I'm giving my clients these tools of transformation that they really love and believe in themselves, and that will happen for the rest of their lives. Like, that really is priceless. You cannot put a value on that. And so when I look at it in that perspective, $15,000 to $20,000 is a steal. Like, that's nothing compared to what it is that they're actually getting for the rest of their lives.
Welcome to Exposed, the show that gives you the raw truth about what it really takes to build a multi-million dollar coaching business and a life that you're obsessed with. I'm your host, Juliana Garcia, marketing strategist and master coach. And after building a multi-million dollar business from scratch, each week, I want to take you behind the scenes with actionable business strategies and profound mindset shifts to help you create wealth from the inside and out, so that you can become the exception to the rule in the coaching industry. I'm exposing the uncomfortable truths, the failures, and the topics that most podcasts don't dare to talk about. So let's dive into today's episode. Hello, everyone. Welcome. I'm so excited for today's episode because I have one of my clients, Emyrald, who is a love coach for high-achieving women, and she helps them attract high caliber, emotionally available men and manifest love in 6 months. And we're going to be talking about selling intangibles. I want all of you to know that if you sell things related to life coaching, love coaching, things that feel like they're not helping people make money, and you wonder, how can I charge premium? How can I get really confident in my price? This episode is going to blow your mind because Emyrald is such an amazing example of what it looks like to elevate your mentality and sell love at a premium price, essentially. So we're going to talk about selling intangibles, even if you don't sell money-making opportunities. And also, we're going to expose the truth about not making your business feel like hard work. If you're feeling like your business is taking a lot of work, we're going to unwind all of that because Emyrald has really had an amazing transformation in that area of her business. So Emyrald, welcome.
Thank you. I'm so excited to be here, Juliana.
Oh my God. Me too. I've been looking forward to this. Okay, so let's get into it. Let's just give people a little bit of context because you are selling love coaching, private coaching to help women manifest love in 6 months for $15,000 to $20,000, depending if they take a VIP day or not. And that sounds amazing. And they're like, wow, you know, that's the end result. But you didn't start there. Tell everyone, what was your journey? Where were you at before you got here?
So when I first started, I was selling sessions at $50 an hour. And it was still like pulling teeth, trying to get people to commit to $50 an hour. And I had one or two clients at that price point, and they were not ideal clients. They didn't show up on time. They canceled last minute. They wanted me to take the notes and send it to them, which of course I did. I was like, please let me prove to you that I'm such a great coach. Let me do everything for you, right? And so at that lower price point, it really was reflective of the amount of investment that they were putting into themselves and their journey. Like, they weren't invested at all. They wanted me to do it for them. And so I started at that low price point, and it took me a while to work my way up. And I know I told you before we hit record that my next big jump was at the 5K mark. It took me a while to get there. I did a group coaching program. It was $300 or $400 a person. Oh, you know what? I think I was charging $3,000 or $4,000 after that. It was either $3,000 pay in full or $1,000 a month for 4 months. And then that was going well. And then I started charging $5K for 6 months. And I had a coach really help me with that because that was hard for me. I was stuck at the 5K for a long time. And then I went up to 10K and again had a coach help me with that because I was terrified. And then 15, and then you've supported me with 20. So it's been a journey. It's been an evolution over the years.
I love that. So what I love about what you're sharing is I like to demonstrate everyone's different path when it comes to elevating into a premium offer and a premium price. Sometimes people literally just jump from one price to the next and they're ready and available to receive that. And it's totally normal to go through milestones. And that actually allows your nervous system to kind of like just feel confident with the next elevation. So even though you were already raising your prices, what was it that attracted you to work together inside of the Magnetize and Monetize Mastermind?
Yeah. And so I had been a coach for 7 years and I kind of felt stuck. Like I was in the feast or famine. I was getting a little bit lazy, which I think a lot of coaches can relate to. Like after being a love coach for so many years, I was like, well, people should just know. I should just put out an offer and they should just buy. Like, why would I have to show that I understand what they're going through, right? It's like, look, this worked for them. It's going to work for you. But I didn't fully understand that the market had changed and that it was completely saturated with so many coaches and people had been burned in the past. And so I'd gotten lazy and then I started to doubt myself. And then my money story came into my coaching business. I started to create up all these ideas that, well, if I wasn't making money, that meant I wasn't a good coach, which of course we know is complete bullshit. But like that was the story that I created of like, it couldn't possibly be that, well, maybe my sales was off or my marketing was off or my copy was off or the market had changed. Or, you know, my story didn't go to that. My story went, okay, I'm not selling and making sales. Therefore, I'm not a good coach. And so I was stuck in that story. And I had remembered you from a year prior. You had done a training in our group through a mutual friend, Katya. I don't know if you remember. And it was just, it was something at the beginning of the year. I was looking at another coach's mastermind and you popped into my head. I just sent you an Instagram message and I was like, hey, are you still doing your mastermind thing? And you were right in the launch and the challenge. And you're like, yep, here's the link. And I joined. I didn't even like watch the pre-launch challenge. And so proof that someone can circle around and join a year later, proof that someone can be a lurker and not even part of your free challenge or your world and still join and sign up. But ultimately, if we go back to your question, like I wasn't feeling confident in myself and my business anymore. I was taking it way too personally. So rather than looking at things from the CEO mindset of, okay, interesting, like why are things going this way? What might need to shift or change? Is it the marketing? Is it the sales? Is it the market? I was like, oh, it's all me, which I think coaches and solopreneurs can relate with.
Oh my God, 100%, especially imagine for a business coach, when they're having dips in their business, like it's so easy to relate it to their own ability to be good coaches because it's like, well, if this is happening for me, then who am I to share or to coach people on this? Is that something that ever happened to you? Let's talk about this because I feel like this is so juicy for people who feel like if you're not a business coach, let's say that you're going through you're a health coach, you're going through a health challenge, and then you lose confidence and like, who am I to coach people on this? So of course you're a coach who has had 7 years of experience helping women with finding love. But has there ever been a time when you have felt like not feeling confident in yourself because of your own results in what you coach?
Well, yeah, because I went through 2 breakups very publicly. And with every breakup, there was the, oh, could I possibly be a good love coach? Because I'm not in a relationship. I'm not married. I haven't been with this person for 10, 20, 30, 40 years. And so I've had to work through those belief systems quite often. And the last 3 years, I chose to be single on purpose. I knew it was necessary for my development as a human being. I really needed to focus on some of the things that came up in my last relationship. I felt strongly called to travel the world, on and on and on. And so I very much had to do the work to move beyond the codependency of my results at that time equal what I'm able to get for my clients, which we know isn't true, right? And so I can also see now, I'm not single right now, but even recently, like when I started dating again, how much more beneficial I was to my clients as a single love coach dating and able to share how I'm dating and what I'm going through rather than, oh, well, I've been married for 10 years and it's amazing. So I don't really understand the current dating culture. I can't help you. And so, of course, in hindsight, I can see how I'm a much better coach because I'm single and dating and what I'm going through. But at the time, it was really hard because I did make up the stories of, okay, well, if I'm not in a relationship, why would someone want to hire me?
Exactly. Oh, I really hope everyone lets this land, whether you need it now, whether you're going through it, or you might need it later. We all go through highs and lows, both in our business and in our personal life. And that, which we're going to talk about in just a minute, how that impacts our ability to believe in our future, believe in what we're capable of, and we just blend everything together. Well, if this is happening in my personal life, that means that I can't create results in my business. That means that I can't be a great coach. And that is just not a helpful way of seeing anything in your life. Because what we're doing is we are immersing ourselves in our experience, our world, so deeply that we forget what the whole purpose of our business is, which is to help people, help clients, and get into their world, get into their thoughts, their feelings, right to where they're at, speak to where they're at, give them solutions for where they're at, and leave our world aside. Like, really, it's like we need to be CEOs instead of being like humans trying to be a CEO, right? It's like we can separate our identity from our business identity. It's so essential, because otherwise we're going to end up in cycles where our belief is going to drop, where it's going to go up and down based on what we're going through in life. And that's why we create inconsistency in our business. When we, let's say, try to feel excited about the business all the time, it's impossible to feel excited about anything at all times, first of all. Number two, your business is not responsible to make you feel anything, to make you feel excited. It's our job to source that from ourselves and then pour into our business the excitement, the consistency that we want our business to have, instead of jamming the whole everything together. And that requires maturity. It requires entrepreneurial experience. And it's something that I love. I mean, we were just coaching on this yesterday, literally.
That really landed well for me, to reiterate what you said around the stability of belief. In that, I mean, I've shared that with so many people. And you said, Emerald, it's not that your business needs to be stable. It's that your belief in your business needs to be stable. And to not be so reactive to the ups and downs, to not make it mean anything. And so even calling it the feast and famine cycle, rather than, well, these are the natural cycles, these are the seasons, we have spring, summer, winter, fall. And if you're launching three times a year, you're going to have higher months three times a year, and it's going to slowly dip down. And so shifting the mindset around it, which again was a big part of taking my money drama out of the business, but then also the practical strategy aspect is, well, how do you create the systems and structures of your business so that you're not starting over every single month? And that was a big part of the reason of why I joined the mastermind, and of course continue to work with you, is to create that stability of structure while also supporting me with the belief system and mindset that's necessary to not be so, I want to say, codependent on how my business is performing. I could say the same thing, not be codependent on if I'm in a relationship or not. Like, that doesn't freaking matter. I'm in integrity in regards to the fact that my processes work. They have worked for hundreds of women personally, tens of thousands in my courses. What does it matter if I'm in a relationship or not? It doesn't. Mm-hmm. What does it matter if I made $1 million last month or not? It doesn't. At the end of the day, my processes work. And what I've learned most from you is how to combine the energy with the practical and strategy.
Can you tell people more about that?
Yeah, absolutely. And so what I call the energy is the belief system, the internal work. The belief in myself, the belief in my business, regardless of how it's doing. When I start to waver or question, like, where are the clients? Like on yesterday's call, it's like, yeah, where are the clients? And to really break down practical ways of, this is where they've come from in the past. And so it's that combination between, you have to do the mindset work, you have to do the subconscious belief work, but then there is the practical. Are you showing up and creating the systems? And so I'm working on doing my group coaching again. And in the beginning, it felt like a lot of work, but then also recognizing I'm going to be launching this program three times a year over and over again. And so all the work that I'm putting in right now, much of it will be able to be replicated in the future. It's going to be this snowball effect. I'm going to build on the testimonials that I have, rather than I'm just doing it once and then I'm done. And so energy, mindset, strategy, well, how are you actually running your business? And I know in the past for me, it's been scattered. It's been all over the place. My fear of getting bored or my fear of losing my freedom has quite honestly been why my business has not grown and kind of plateaued, because I haven't been really strategic in how I'm running it.
Yeah. Okay, beautiful. Thank you so much for sharing that. It makes so much sense. So tell me, why did you decide to join the Magnetize and Monetize Mastermind without even going to my live event, without doing anything? You were just like, I'm ready, let's go. And this, the reason why I want to ask that is because I want everyone listening to hear what people are actually buying. What do they need in order to buy? They don't need all the bells and whistles sometimes, majority of the time. So many of my clients don't even read the sales page. They don't attend my live streams. They never comment. They never engage. But somehow they end up paying $10,000 in full and they want to get started. Let's go. And so I want people to understand, what does a premium client think like? Like, what is that? Because you're a premium client. You did that. And so tell everybody what that decision making was like for you. Why did you decide to join specifically that container?
So in hindsight, I can see that it was the trifecta of trust, the trifecta of belief that you teach within the mastermind, that I believed in you. So you had the confidence in what it is that you were selling. You also had the social proof. You had the testimonials. You had all of that, which at the time I wasn't really looking at, but that was in the back of my mind from a year earlier when I had discovered you. And so I really believed in you. I believed in the program. I did read the sales page. Absolutely. I did see how much it cost. I did see all of the testimonials. And then ultimately, I believed in myself. So I was, for the last year, I was trying to do it on my own and it wasn't getting me further. Then I was in the exact same spot a year later. I was like, all right, this isn't working. And so I did believe in my ability, but I knew I needed a guide. And so I believed in you. I believed in the program and I believed in my ability to get there, which I now know is the trifecta. Is it trust or belief?
Yeah, belief. Amazing. Okay, so I want to get into the actual practical things that you did in order to solidify your confidence in your price, in order for you to have some of your highest cash months, signing people at the rates that you wanted. And at the end of Magnetize, you sold over $33,000 after feeling like there was a lull. So let's get into the things that you actually did.
So the biggest thing for me personally was the belief system work. Like, I already had the business, I already had the structure, I'd already been coaching and I had the sales pages, you know, like that really didn't need to be tweaked huge. It was seeing the value of what I was offering, right? And so when I first started my coaching business, it was the $50 an hour. So I was looking at it as a per session rather than this is the package price for 6 months. But also this is the value of transformation that they get for the rest of their lives. And so I remember specifically like breaking down everything that my clients learned and went through and how they up-leveled, how so many of them got like unexpected bonuses and promotions and job changes, manifested free cars as gifts. Like, it's kind of insane, actually, the amount of positive things that have happened for my clients over the years, in addition to healing relationships with family members, with friends, et cetera, et cetera. And so I've had clients say, Emyrald, one session with you was more powerful than the years of therapy I've had. And so when I really started to look at things in the bigger picture, how much are people spending on therapy? What's the emotional cost of having this unhealthy relationship with your stepmother, for example? But then also, what's the monetary bonuses of like, holy shit, the majority of my clients have gotten $10,000 to $50,000 raises while working together. Like, well, that's a no-brainer. And so I started looking at all of this together in addition to what's the value of being in a healthy relationship, or what's the cost of being in an unhealthy relationship? What's the cost of divorce financially, emotionally, on the kids, et cetera, et cetera. And just the bigger long-term picture of I'm giving my clients these tools of transformation that they really love and believe in themselves, and that will happen for the rest of their lives. Like, that really is priceless. You cannot put a value on that. And so when I look at it in that perspective, 15 to 20K is a steal. Like, that's nothing compared to what it is that they're actually getting for the rest of their lives.
So good. Okay, perfect. I want to get into what you actually did in order to get behind your price. And this is a concept that I help my clients really apply to their business in order to feel so congruent with their pricing. And that is an exercise that I give you guys to really quantify the time, the money, and the energy that people are spending and investing in other ways that is costing them more than if they just invested with you in your program. So the key to that is
to shift your mindset from, okay, I'm selling 8 sessions for 3 months, or the program has to be 3 months, therefore what most coaches are charging for 3 months of, you know, love coaching. Instead of looking at what other people are doing, instead of looking at time, money, and that concept, we want to think about the value. And people get confused when they hear value. How do I give value? How do I quantify the value? Well, it's very simple. You want to think about the lifelong value of working with you instead of thinking, how much am I charging? Is that too much? Is my client going to be able to pay it? Are other coaches charging that? When you get into that conversation, you know you're creating destructive thinking around your pricing. Instead, when you get into proactive thinking around your pricing and really the reality of what it means to coach someone for not just for the 3 months, but the results they're going to experience in their lifetime, everything changes in your mind. So time, money, and energy are the three areas that premium clients really value, and really anyone, but especially premium clients. And so we want to really start understanding, okay, how is my client wasting money by not working with me? How is that going to cost them so much more to not work with me than actually invest the $20,000? Even though that seems like a big number, how can we really see the cost of not working with me? So yesterday we were talking about that for your clients. And so let's talk a little bit about what that looks like for your clients specifically who are thinking about hiring someone. And why is $20,000 a drop in the ocean? Let's just demonstrate what that looks like.
Yeah. And there's so many ways. I mean, let's even just talk about the practical aspects of living with someone. It's just cut in half, right? I mean, okay, your food cost. The food cost would be a little bit more, but for all intents and purposes, like rent didn't double, your utilities didn't double, trips and vacations, it's the same price for a hotel room for one as it is for two. So there's
so true.
Practical, physical aspects. I think about like when I move in with a partner again one day, it's like he's already paying his mortgage. So like, let's say I'm not paying rent anymore. How much does that save me per year?
Oh my God, I did not think about this. Is so good. Yes. Yeah. I'm sure a lot of people will be like, that's not true. I pay half, whatever. That's up to you. The situation is just simply like traveling. That is so true. Like I travel alone. I book a room and it's for two people. Like all rooms are like two people minimum. Right. I'm like, oh, this is interesting. Even if we were going halves, although a high quality man will always provide. Yeah. That is so fascinating that it is so true. I actually never thought about that one.
Yeah.
The one that I wanted to talk about that I think is brilliant because I give this example in my live trainings, like, you know, how much are men who are looking for love spending in, you know, dating the wrong women and not having a love coach to help them shortcut the time? And it's so easy for men because men spend a lot of money on dating, like in dating, taking women out on dates. I mean, literally, my friend just confirmed this the other day. He's like, I'm going on 3 dates a week. Each date is $200. That's something. I'm spending like $600 a week. And that total is like $30,000. Now, the woman is not spending that kind of money. So you could argue, well, it's not the same. This doesn't apply when you're coaching women. Not true. And I can tell you from personal experience, dating the wrong guy can have a huge impact in your ability to show up for your career, for your business, having creative thought to make more money, to create new ideas. And I have seen this over and over again with women who are peers, who are friends. And like the moment that they start dating somebody who is not the right fit, emotionally unavailable, inconsistent, literally their attention goes into like, has he messaged me? Has he messaged me? Like, right. Is it, you know? And it literally feels like the only thing you can think about. Like yeah. Your entire being feels consumed by that because it's an unhealthy relationship. And that has a direct impact in your business, like period, in your career, in your performance.
Yeah, and I've also had the opposite experience in clients as well. When you're with the right guy, they're supporting you emotionally. Sometimes like I remember when I had a cafe, my ex was there. He was washing dishes. He was putting in signposts. He was going to the grocery store. And so there is also that physical, emotional, maybe even intellectual. Like I've had past clients where their partners are now investing in their business. They're a silent partner, or they have different ideas and skill sets that they can bring to the table. And so it truly is the power of two people coming together that are high value, high vibe, high caliber, whatever, versus I'm a high-value woman or man, and I'm not in the right relationship. It takes away from your life force in so many ways.
Oh my God. It's so, 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 so good. I mean, I think that I just want everyone to think about that for your own business, because we could come up with 100. This is the power of having a coach, right? Like, I don't know, had you ever thought about your price in that way before we worked together? Believe around your price and $20,000 being a drop in the ocean in that manner.
No, it was more just revolved around the price of the program. And that's where my money drama was there. I was like, oh my God, that's so much money. Then the value of what it is and the bigness of it. And even now it feels like that's like so little of a price. I kept charging a whole lot more. And now I understand why other coaches can charge $50,000, $100,000, $200,000 for their coaching packages, because they really are in alignment with the value in the bigness of it. It's not, well, this is what it costs to work with me for 6 months, but this is the value of what the transformation is that I'm offering you for the rest of your life.
Yeah. So beautiful. I always say to clients, get out of your clients' wallets, because that is none of your business. Your only job is to really think about, how is this the best thing for my client? How is working with me the best thing for my client? And really selling yourself on the value of that, getting really clear and taking your brain to that level, because you can have, I think what makes a great coach is somebody who's able to give you a perspective that serves you in a really impactful way. That's what I offer my clients, is just perspectives that they haven't seen before that allows them to really actually believe something deeply, instead of like trying to believe it, but actually they see it, they feel it. They're like, oh my God, that makes total sense. So for everyone listening, just really take that and really start thinking about, are you feeling confident in your price? And if not, okay, quantify. What is the time, energy, and money that people are wasting by not working with you? And really take your brain, not just for those 6 months, but the lifelong cost and gain also that they will have if they had that time back, if they had that energy back, if they had money back instead of spending it on things that don't work. How much money would they be saving? How much money would they be making if they had the energy to be thriving, be peaceful, be relaxed, I mean, etc. So that's such a powerful exercise. Okay, so let's move on to the next thing that you did inside of our work together that really helped you elevate to attracting high caliber clients.
So one of the other big things I've learned is that there is a direct correlation behind the bigger the investment, the bigger the commitment. And that's not to say just go out and charge $100,000 for your coaching. An example that was given to me once is, how much do you value a $5,000 car versus a $50,000 car versus a $500,000 car? And when I was charging $50 a session, the women weren't really committed. Versus when I'm charging $15,000, they're showing up to my free stuff, they're taking notes, they're doing the work, like they are so committed because they're valuing the money they're spending. Now, mind you, of course, there's exceptions. There could be men and women out there that throw away $15,000 without even thinking about it. But in general, I would say that when you spend more money on yourself, you're much more willing to value it and show up and do the work. And that right there is a premium client. Those are the clients that are going to get the results. And then I get more testimonials. I feel better about the work that I'm doing because it's giving the results. Now, I did have to work my way up to the belief system and seeing the value behind what it is that I am offering my clients. But in general, I just want to remind people that what I really have learned is that we do value things that are more expensive. Mm. And not because of the price per se, but if we're investing that amount of money, we show up and do the work.
100%. And also, there are cases where people pay a lot of money and can be a pain in the butt.
Yeah, for sure.
And that's why inside of Magnetize, I always teach, we want to speak to the empowered version of your client, because who cares if somebody is willing to pay you $20,000 for your love coaching, but if they're like, go and I pay you a lot of money, go do the work for me. I pay you a lot of money, this should be happening faster. I pay you a lot of money. That is not the vibe. And the job of your marketing, the job of your messaging is to really elevate the mentality of people who may have a tendency to think that way, to really shift it, or just simply speak to the people who are already in a place where they know that the results come from their mind, their thoughts, and their actions, that results are their responsibility. So it's important to remember that money also doesn't equate a perfect, amazing client. You can still get people to pay you money, but if they're going to be a drain, then it's just going to feel so heavy. And one of the things that we do inside Magnetize is really speak to those delicious clients that are just like, of course I want to pay. And of course I want to show up. And of course I'm going to show up in a premium way.
Bingo.
Yes. Okay, my love. For everyone who's listening, I'm just curious to hear your thoughts around what does it feel like to be coached by me? And I want you to be like really transparent, expose the truth to the world, because my coaching is very, very specific flavor. It's definitely for people who are willing to hear the truth. And so I'm just curious, how would you say it in your own words? We've been working together for a while now. So how would you express it to the world?
It is sweet and savage at the same time. And oftentimes you'll ask, you're like, do you want me to be sweet or savage? And I would say 90% of the time, all the other women are like, give it to me, savage. You're like, we want it. We want the truth. We want to hear it because we want to learn. We want to grow. We want to move beyond our own shit. And sometimes though, we do need the sweetness. Sometimes it's like, can you just tell me that it's all going to be okay? And then tomorrow you can tell me what the fuck to do and rub it in my face. And so, yeah, the thing is, like, you are this perfect combination, at least for me, right? Like, I am the same way. I am sweet, but savage. Like, I am blunt and I'm straight and tell my clients what's up, but I also can be loving and understanding and kind and in my heart. And so coaching with you, like, you are kind, you were sweet, you were direct, you were loving, but you're also savage. You're like, this is what you need to know if you want to shift and change and grow your business. Like, simple as that. And that's what I really appreciate about you. And that's why I'm here. And I think that's why all the other women are here and stick around in the mastermind as well, because that's what we want. We want that tough love.
I love that. I love that. Okay. And what's an example of something that I have recently coached you on that relates to what we talked about in the beginning of this podcast, which is how to stop making your business feel like hard work?
Yeah.
Well, what was the savage coaching that I gave you?
So it was yesterday in our mastermind call. And as you know, I've been in resistance to my launch for like the last month now. And like over the last month, you're like, fine, then don't do it and see how that goes for you. Learn the lesson. And then I did finally start putting it all together. And then on yesterday's call, I was like, I feel overwhelmed. Like, this is a lot. And so just kind of broke it down. You're like, well, what's overwhelming? You're like, well, I'm like, well, the amount of work. Like, I have to write posts. I have to do reels. I have to do live streams and coaching. You're like, well, Emerald, isn't that what you're already doing? It's like, yeah. I was like, but then I need to do it for the group coaching and then blah, blah, blah. And you're like, Emerald, we're just talking about the launch here. Like, stop. Get out of your mind. Like, you're overwhelmed because you're making it into this big deal and it's nothing more than what you're already doing. Like, yeah, okay, I guess you're right.
Emerald was really committed to feeling overwhelmed. I was like, okay, you can choose to feel overwhelmed, but like, that's completely optional. And that's the coaching that I gave you. Okay, great. You don't want to do that. Even before I told you, you're actually already doing it, but cool. You don't have to do it that way. What do you love doing?
I was like, I like doing live streams and coaching and writing.
And then I'm like, isn't that what you're already doing? And then you're like, oh, you're right.
So this is changing the mindset from overwhelm to, let's just say, excitement, right? It's like, well, what do you love to do? And it's like, yeah, what you're already doing. And so bring that joy into the live streams and the reels and the emails and all of that.
I always say we have to find a way for, if we ever feel so much resistance towards something, instead of just like forcing ourselves to do it, we want to like really just work with what we're really great at. What do we love doing? Because a business coach can give us, or as a marketing coach, I give you guys guidelines and very specific things that you can do. But I always say you need to adapt it to yourself, to your business. You cannot be like a copy paste of me unless it works for you. But it's just not necessary to force yourself into some kind of cage or some kind of formula. It's just about taking business principles that always work and then adjusting to like, cool, if she's teaching me this, how could I adapt to something that I just feel really delicious doing? Like, how could this work for me in my own way? And then doing the damn thing. And it turns out that you literally love speaking, you love coaching, you love writing. I'm like, that is basically what you do when you launch. And we can just make that the core of it. And it was such a simple shift, but people spend hours, time, like years overwhelmed by launches, thinking that it's hard and feel when it's like, actually, you're not seeing it. You're not relating to it in the most delicious way. And that's what we want to do.
Yeah. Not making our businesses hard. Like, exactly. It's going to be work, but it doesn't have to be hard work. It can be enjoyable. It can be infused with what you love. Just like my physical body, it doesn't feel like hard work to be healthy because I do the activities I love, like yoga and biking and hiking and making delicious food. Like, yes, it's work, but it doesn't have to be hard.
100%. All right, my love. So
What would you say to somebody who is thinking about joining Magnetize and who is on the fence?
Okay. So what I would say is that you have to be the premium client. You have to be willing to show up and do the work. Don't join the program because Juliana is going to save you and her processes are going to save you. Show up and do the work, and I promise the work will work for you. Really as simple as that. And I can say I sat on the fence for a year. I thought I could do it by myself. I waited, and that's fine. But then when I did actually do it, I showed up from this empowered mindset of I'm the one who's going to make this happen. I believe in her. I believe in her processes, and I believe in me. And that's not to say that I was 180% confident in myself, although I think I was very much like, I'm going to fucking make this happen. I was like so committed. But even if you have a little bit of self-doubt, but if you believe in Juliana and you believe in the program, I would say absolutely do it because everything I have learned in it, like I wish you were the first marketing program that I found 7 years ago when I started my coaching business. Why am I still in the mastermind with you? Why am I right now thinking like, I wish I could work with you forever? I'm like, you're exceptional at what you do. And I want to continuously like not only take in your energy and belief systems, but then also the practical strategy behind copy and marketing that is so priceless in the online world nowadays as a coach.
So essential. Well, I'm so honored that I get to be in your corner. I love being by your side. I take no credit for your results. Everything you've done, it's been really what you said, it's been you. You decided to go show up and do the damn thing. And just be coachable and be open and be receptive and so like open. When my clients are open and receptive and they're like, okay, I'm willing to just like receive. I'm like, great. All you need to do is just receive and then implement. And then you'll just literally see your entire life change so quickly instead of feeling like, well, I've already done that. I already know that. I could have done easier. I could have. And just resist the coaching. It's just like, no, open up, do the damn thing. You're good. And life gets to be simple. So thank you so much for being here and being an amazing example of what's possible. Let's just tell everyone where they can find you in case they want to work with you.
Yeah, absolutely. So I love my Instagram at Manifest with Emyrald is Instagram. I have a book, Destination Soulmate. I have a website, Emyrald Sinclaire, and my podcast, Manifest It All. But truly, I would say Instagram because that is my jam and that is this platform that I'm on all the time.
Yeah, I love following you. It's the best. Best storytelling and like, oh my God, all your dating adventure is so fun. I'm like, ah! All right, my love, thank you so much for being here. Thank you everyone for listening. I'll see you guys on the next episode. Mwah! Bye. Bye.
Thank you so much for tuning in. Look, I'm going to be honest. I never like leaving reviews or sharing episodes unless it's something that really moved me. So if this show resonated with you today, please leave a review. It would mean the world to me. And send it to somebody who really wants to know the raw, exposed truth about what it really takes to create a $1 million business and a delicious life. And as a thank you, I'm gifting you a free mini course about the 3 mistakes that coaches make that repel premium clients and how to fix it so that you can start attracting clients now. Check out the show notes to access it, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.